the academy started in 2009, and it needed somebody to take it to a new place. Somebody who actually understood what the people within it actually needed. And for me, it was absolutely vital that the whole being of the academy fostered ingenuity, creativity, and innovation. It had to inculcate all the values that I think the best entrepreneurs have, the best scientists, the best geniuses, the most artistic people in the world have. It's this sense of freedom to explore what it is you wish to explore.
Technology was not the key focus around delivering the vision. The key focus was around learning, and to make sure that every student had 21st century resources. And this whole building and the innovations that we've put within it are around creativity. So whether it's the curriculum, whether it's the technology, whether, you know, it's our pastoral system, you know, the whole thing is actually centered around, you know, the creative use of ideas and innovation. So one of the key things with the deployment of this technology is, number one, it's very easy for teachers to actually use it, which, and number two, it works, which then leads on to number three, that actually teachers feel comfortable using it. It becomes embedded as part of their learning experience. And it's something that students also begin to get used to in terms of their experiences of learning as well.
There was two levels of effectiveness from our managed service provider, Northgate, that were very, very important. One was the response that Northgate as an organisation provided to our ever-changing needs. And what we found was that Northgate was willing to join us on that journey. And that was critical because it provided the impetus for the next step, which was the second advantageous element, where once procurement started and a baseline had been agreed, the installation was very good. There's a commitment to agility and a commitment for employees to work within the culture of this organisation. And we've seen a considerable benefit from our provider in the way they have shown their commitment to doing something that they hadn't previously done anywhere else.
Take, for example, the Apple TV that we've installed throughout the academy. Teachers are able to send content directly to that screen. To actually install that infrastructure, it's quite a task and quite a challenge because it's not been done before. And for that reason, Northgate did that extremely well. Certainly, Northgate have been, you know, extremely flexible with us. For example, you know, the imaging of the MacBook devices, you know, 86 staff coming in, opening the devices and logging on and so on. And this continues to be a service that Northgate delivers very well.
Since the school turned to an academy, we've experienced many changes, technology being a colossal change. It's totally and utterly different. It's more exciting, it's entertaining. But now we've got the ability to use so many different things, and, you know, we can tailor it towards the students' needs.
ICT is excellent for the classroom because it takes us away from the restriction of what information is provided in the books. It brings more independence for the students to think creatively, and if questions come up, to allow them to take the initiative to find the information out for themselves. Ever since we got the MacBooks, because there's so much more available on there, for example with Keynotes, it's great how I can just make one resource and I can use that again and again with other classes.
One benefit of the technology would be in basketball, where you could, as a member of staff or even a student, find the perfect model on, let's say, for example, a YouTube clip that could be displayed and played to the entire group. And then each individual student could take turns to record their own performance, and then we could marry up the two.
I think the benefits of this technology would be that when they do enter the working world out there, they will go in much more confident and have just a strong position as a candidate to whatever job they go for.
The feedback that we're we're receiving from the students is really, really positive. In terms of the actual behaviour, we've seen a recognised improvement because they actually want to be involved, they want to take leadership of their own learning. For my BTEC groups and my GCSE groups, I see massive grade improvements.
In science, we rely heavily on technology, and it has to be robust in order for our lessons to go to plan.
And you've got a fantastic team on hand that if any time an issue does come up, they can resolve it straight away.
Because the whole school's wireless, it enables us to be able to learn anywhere. Because say if you wanted to go and do, the teacher said go and do research, now you can do it within 10 seconds.
It helps us in our lessons to, you know, take notes when the teacher's giving a lecture to help you when you're doing your own work independently.
Basically, the one that we use the most is the iPods. We're able to take that home, and if, for example, you're maybe not sure about a homework that you were set at school, you're able to email your teacher straight away and you're able to get that reply at the instant, then you're able to complete your work for the next day, and that's something we never had in the past.
Everything's going to change soon, everything's going to be technology based, and then Essa's already ahead, and then it's going to help us in the future. I feel lucky because we're at one of the most ahead schools in Britain at the moment. And I don't want to go to anywhere else, I want to stay here because of this new building and all the technology and all everything, the iPods, the iPads, the iMacs, the MacBook.
Imagine being in an environment where a student could take a textbook home that's completely personalised for them. That's the sort of environment that we're creating here, and we're very much moving in that direction very rapidly.
So what I see in the medium to long term is the technology getting better and better and better, enabling us to personalise further and further so that our young people succeed to go on and make a difference from generation to generation.